It was a dark and stormy night. Sheesh. On a distant corner of Pandora, where few men dare to tread. With the journey to find the elusive vault behind them, our fearless adventurers set off into the trees of...
What's a tree?
Oh, for the angel's sake. It's a plant that grows out of the ground really tall.
Like this?
No more interruptions. So, they set out into the trees of Jacob's Cove, a land very much ravaged and forgotten by time. It was here that the scientist Dr. Nate, who is totally not Dr. Zed from the last story at all, tried to help all of mankind, but ultimately caused very bad shit.
That's a swear!
Dude made zombies, okay? You're not the police of me. Pay attention. Okay, so some bad crap was happening, and it got really spooky, and this is when our story begins.
Is any of this going to be true?
Yes. Probably a lot of it. You're adopted.
Misinformed zombie fodder? I am not affiliated with the Jacobs Corporation, but they've hacked me to tell people like you that they would appreciate some assistance with the overwhelming situation with the living impaired. I should warn you, though, that they'll suck your brain out of your cranial cavity like a crappuccino if you get too close. If you'd still like to help, I suggest you turn on the town's defenses. Otherwise, crappuccino. Toodles!
Thank you.
intense. I'm sure glad I'm not made of tasty flesh like you. The town should be safe for now, but if you're really going to solve the zombie infestation, you're gonna need to talk to Dr. Ned. He's been trying to fix the problem, and I'm sure he could use a hand. You'll find him at his office down on the docks. I'll open the waterfront gate so you can be on your way. Let's go! Jacob's Cove. Good luck. Killer. New missions are available at the Jacob's Cove Bounty Board. Dr. Ned gave me the following awards this year. Most effective claptrap in life-threatening situations, hottest performer of mid-80s breakdance fighting, master orator, and best kisser.
Thank you. Anna. I've arrived at Jacob's Cove, and you'll be pleased to know it seems a jolly and lively old town. I know being away from you and the children will be difficult, but it's only for a few cycles. The pay is just too generous to pass up. I'll work hard here and be back to you and the girls soon. My brother will take good care of you in the meantime. Love, Hank.
It's hard to seek new opportunities with old equipment. Upgrade now. Tor combines good damage, high fire rate, and recoil reduction into one lethal weapon. Jacob's guns do one thing really well. Power. And honestly, what else do you need?
Pooped right where you're standing.
Atlas spares no expense in making guns that excel in every area.
Here is tough, but honest. Oh, and the trees, Anna. The trees are amazing. You wouldn't believe your eyes. I've never seen anything like them. Sometimes I feel sad to cut them down, but it will all be worth it if I can get back to you with the money required for us to have a fresh start. I'm dreaming about a nice homestead in the Dahl Headland. Think on it. Missing you, Hank. Yes. Tell Sally that I love the hat she sent. I wear it every day. The men tease me a bit, but they don't know the joy that a child's love can bring. been noticing some strange things at the mill of late. Many workers seem to be falling very ill. What is strange is that we all had our checkups just last week and were given a clean bill of health and a vitamin from the company's physician, Dr. Ned. He's doing everything in his power, but there have been some deaths. Do not worry. I will, as always, be careful. I'll send an echo again soon. All my love, Hank.
It has been brought to the executive leadership of the Jacobs Corporation that certain anti-Jacobs propaganda has been circulating, proclaiming that we are somehow responsible for not supplying evacuation from the sudden fatal passing of 97% of the workforce. We would like to remind the surviving 3% that we are not a taxi service, and for the spread of this material will result in a write-up with HR.
Checks and shorties up my grill,
but the lifetime.
Anna. Things have gone from bad to worse. There have been rumors of people seeing the dead walk. At first, these tales were laughed off at the saloon, but now people talk in the hushed whispers of the truth. They say that those who come in contact with the dead are always the first to be ill and are, as such, the first to seek the help of Dr. Ned. The doctor assures me that he's making progress on a cure. I, for one, believe him, and it is only 3 more weeks till we are reunited. Kiss the girls for me. Love, Hank. Beloved Anna. It is no longer rumors. Some curse has been set upon us here at Jacob's Cove. The dead are rising from their graves and are ravenous with a hunger for flesh. All work has stopped, and we're fighting for our lives. But fear not. Dr. Ned believes there's a way to stop the horror. I have volunteered to allow him to test an antidote on me. It's the Skags, my dear. The filthy Skags will be our salvation. The doctor says they're immune to the ailment. I'm presently on my way to get this treatment at the hospital outside of town. I know it will be a success, and we will be together again shortly. Pray for me.
Everybody's doing the claptrap. Let's kick zombies for the thrills. Checks and shorties up
my grill, but the life kind.
I am Atlas, and you too can see what it feels like to hold the power of the gods in your hands.
Good. That must have hurt. some blood!
Brain soup, brain tacos, brains a la mode, brain pie, brains and cream, brain-filled donut, brains over easy, scrambled brains, poached brains, brains Benedict.
some blood.
That must have hurt.
Show me some blood. Huh!
fried brains, stag fried brains, boiled brains, boil them, mash them, stick them in a stew, kosher brains, brain fondue, stir fried brains, raw brains, brains on a stick.
Oh.
some blood!
Huh!
Huh.